Why hello there, thank you for joining me for this little regex tutorial in C#. Basically, a few weeks ago I asked myself, what exactly is regex? Or regex, as I like to call it. I don't know if that's correct, but anyway. Basically, in my work, which I started last year, I here and there come about some kind of string or a bunch of strings where I think, hey, this would be really easy to split or replace if the computer just knew, hey, it's not just this specific string, or it's this string that follows this specific pattern. And usually, I looked at regex and was like, yeah, I have no idea what's going on here. And I just did it some other way, with very complicated string splits, for loops, for each loops, and the like. But then finally, I got the opportunity to actually look into this at work. And now that I think about it, it's actually not that bad once you have a little look at it and try it out for a few times. And I hope that with these little examples that I present to you now, that maybe I can take away the fear for some people out there. So let's jump right in. Here I've prepared a few examples for you, which we'll go through within the next few minutes. But before we do this, we have to go into the flash of regex and be like, okay, we actually have to figure out what the hell is going on here. And for this, we're going to look at the quick reference of Microsoft, since they developed the C# language, and we're going to look at the most basic examples. And even with just those, we can already do a lot of very interesting stuff that would help you reduce your workload, which you would have if you were just to use the string class, for example, string replace and string split. Basically, regex is its own little class that has a type of symbol language. You use these different symbols with backslashes to tell the program or a computer, hey, here is a little pattern I want to introduce to you, and I would like you to search the specific string for this pattern and maybe give me matches or replace this match. And you can tailor your patterns based on these different keywords or key phrases that they have defined for you. I'm not going to go through all of those, because in our examples, we just use very basic ones that you will be able to use in your daily life already. But just let me pick out the ones I consider the most important ones. First, we have the, I think it's a backslash, as I'm not a native speaker, so let's call this the backslash. This basically tells us, okay, in regex speech, if it's not already a predefined character or symbol that regex will recognize, or if it's one that could be ambiguous, for example, in C#, we have escape characters and normal strings, then we have to precede it with a backslash so that it will know, okay, he or she wants that specific backslash or that specific symbol that's after this backslash here. Then we have so-called character classes, which we will come back to in a few seconds. But first I want to have the, yes, exactly. I want to have the one symbol groups. They are basically the same as these character groups. And character groups are basically an ASCII or UTF range. I think I have only used ASCII so far, but I suppose your UTF would be possible in some point as well. Basically, you can say, hey, okay, I want to have a specific group. I'm going to define for you what is in this group. In this case, it's an A and a E. I'm sorry, my English is leaving me. And the computer will say, okay, the person just told me only these patterns are supposed to be in this position, and so they will match only A and E at this specific position, as you can see here in the matches. You can also say, okay, I have my character group here, and then precede it with this. Yeah, I'm sorry, I have no idea what it's called in English. So in German, it would be a Dach. So with this symbol here, you can say everything defined here, not. So basically negate this group. Everything that's not defined here will be matched. So anything but A, I, and E will be matched in this case. If you're a bit lazy, like myself, or if you have a larger group, you can also say, hey, okay, you know ASCII, right? I do too. So you just start at this ASCII character, and up to this ASCII character, you everything that's in that range, you match that, please. And most of the time you see this in the form of like A to Z, 0 to 9, small or lowercase a to Z, and the like. For example, when you want to define a hexadecimal number range. The point operator is basically the wild card, which you can see here. It will match anything that comes between this A and E if it's a normal ASCII character. For example, a V in this case in Nabe, which I suppose is Latin at this point. Then there's some constructs I haven't used yet. Maybe you can look into it once you've gotten a taste for regex. And then finally come some of the very important ones, maybe the most important ones if you're at the beginning. The backslash W, small w by the way, regex by default is case sensitive unless you tell it not to be. But these keywords here are always case sensitive, so be aware of that. Backslash W, or lowercase w, tells you please match any word character. And as you can see here, that will match anything that's a number, or rather a digit, or a letter in the alphabet. But not, for example, a point, and also not something like a tab or a new line. If we have it in uppercase, as we see directly below, it matches anything but these word characters. So for example here, it would match the white space and the point. White space themselves also have their own keyword. S for space, I would suppose, lowercase, and then consequently S uppercase matches any non-white space character. Then finally, we have small d for any digit, so 0 to 9, or 0 through 9, and then everything that's not inherently a digit. Now, if we have such patterns, we might at some point say, okay, this pattern can actually repeat, but I don't want to type out a specific pattern like 15 times in a row, when I know it can come anywhere from 0 to 15 times at this point. And for this, we have for one, grouping constructs. The most important one is here, the sub-expression, where we can tell it, hey, everything in here, that belongs together, please be aware of that. And this we can use at a later point with quantifiers. And quantifiers are really important because they basically are like for loops for the regex expression. And you can be very specific, for example, when you use the curvy brackets or parentheses, and tell them, hey, please do this number, then this tells them, or tells the program, this expression, or this digit, please match it 3 times, exactly 3 times. Or, if you follow it up with a comma, it will be at least 3 times, or at least 2 times, as in the example. Now, if you know it's at least 2 times, for example, or at least 10 times, you can also do n, m, then it will match anything in between these ranges. And there's of course also shorthand for this. The most common ones have their shorthands. There we have the asterisk, which matches 0 times or an infinite number of times, so 0 or more. The plus sign, which matches 1 or more times. And finally the question mark, which matches 0 or 1 times. Which is, for example, very important when checking emails, because there could be a point before the at sign, or there could be several, or there could be none. Depends. We will see that in an example, actually. So I know it's a bit dry if I just read off these different quantifiers to you, and I possibly have lost a few people watching this video already, but now let's actually see this in action. I have prepared a few examples, and one of the first one that came to mind to me was how, for example, would I validate a list of MAC addresses that I get, for example, from another program or from a coworker? Because let's be honest, at some point, maybe someone was messing around with, I don't know, a program like nmap and was randomly generating these things to overload something, and we have to filter through the list and find out what was actually worth something. We would be able to use regex to say, okay, is this a valid MAC address or is it not? So here I have a little list for you. We can quickly go through them to see which one should be valid and which shouldn't. So you go here, hexadecimal, as we know, B9, H3, H is not hexadecimal, so this shouldn't be valid. 99, 11, 22, ABC, this is valid. 10, 11, A0, B6, 5, 5, 5, FF, this is not valid because we have 3 digits here, which would mean we go over the assigned length of a normal MAC address bitwise. And finally, 57 BCDD 991177, that should also be valid. So the first and the third MAC address are not valid. And we would like to create a regex expression that would find this out for us, so we don't have to sift through a line of a giant string array, for example, with 5,000 entries. We wouldn't want to do that. We want regex to do this for us. So therefore, we have to use the regex clause. First of all, we have to think about what this pattern means. Basically, we know we have a certain amount of hexadecimal symbols, and we do not know at this point if they can be lowercase or not, so we're just going to be on the safe side and use a group where we define what ASCII characters we would like to match, as we can see here with the rigid brackets. I'm sorry, I don't know the word at this point. So we say, okay, it can either be A to F lowercase, A to F uppercase, or 0 to 9. So we have all the symbols that can be in a hexadecimal number. And then we know there can be, there are two at least at the beginning. So we say there come exactly two. So we would match two hexadecimal digits. And then it depends. In this case, we have a division with a double point, but maybe this is not the case. So it's not necessary that there is one. So we can say, okay, hey, there could be a double point, please match that, but only 0 or 1 times. So there can be a double point, but there doesn't need to be. And this is what this expression tells us. Now you can see here, we match this 2 times, and then there comes this double point. But we know that this is 1 unit. This can repeat. We have it here, then here, here, here. So this comes several times, and actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times, 48 bits. And that's why we use the normal brackets or parentheses to form a sub-expression. And this sub-expression we know can only should occur 6 times. And this we can use to basically tell the regex clause how a MAC address looks. And now it will know what a valid MAC is and what it isn't. For this, we can build a string. This isn't really necessary at this point. I just did it to simulate something where we'd get an actual string instead of a string array, but that's not that important. So basically, once we have our pattern, we can use this pattern down here to create an actual new regex clause instance. And based on this instance, we will do the regex magic. So here we will write out the valid MAC addresses. And in order to get the results of a matching of a regex against the pattern, we can use in this case regex.matches. This will return to us a match collection, which contains all the matches that were found. You can also use the singular regex.match, which will give you exactly the first match, but I wanted to have all of them. And basically we're adding them to our string builder over here, so we can print them down. We can print them out in the end. So basically, we're gonna run this really quick. We already established what we should have, or what our results should be. So this one was invalid, and this too. So we should have 99 and 57. Of course, it opened on the wrong side of the screen. Just one moment. There we go. So we see, he tells us, these are the matches I found. So we have 99, 11, 22, AA, BC. Valid, 57, BC, DD, 99, 11, 77. Valid. So we picked out the two valid MAC addresses based on our pattern here. Very nice indeed. So this is already a pretty nice example. I would like to show you maybe one or two more, depending on how good we are in the time. Let's see. I have another example with a mail validity check, a splitting example, and a splitting example. So yeah, you know, let's just do all of them. Why not? We do have time after all, don't we? So let's just comment this in again. And here we should see it. As you know, there are different rules for how and when an email address is valid. The ones I'm using here are currently more than one @ sign. And if there is an underscore in the domain. Aside from that, we'll just have to assume at this point that the email is valid, because I'm going into every RFC standard here would be a bit exhaustive, so I'm just going to show this little example. So based on this, we see here we have two @ signs that should be invalid. This one should be valid. Jeff@amazon.com, which by the way is a legitimate email address, or was at least, was the one Jeff Bezos took when he founded Amazon. Then my example site to work should also work, because subtraction sign, I think it's called here, is valid, and this one is invalid because it has an underscore. So we know this one should be invalid and this one. Now, again, how do we tell this to the computer? With this, exactly. So here you can see one of the pitfalls that actually hurt me a lot in the job at one point. The regex language only recognizes one backslash. So you have to account for this when you build your string in C#, that you have these escape characters. So for example, when you're using regex on JSON, that can escalate really quickly. So you have like 4 backslashes or 6 when you want to match slashes themselves in the JSON. So be aware of that. Now basically, what have we done? We are matching spaces here, because again, I was like, hey, let's make a string out of this, because why not? It's not like it's totally inefficient at this point. Just bear with me. I'm sorry for that. Then we match again the normal alphabet A to Z, and A to Z in capitals as well as numbers, because you can be yolomaster22@hotmail.com, for example. We match that at least once. And here is why we do that. Because, as you can see here, max.master.man@yahoo.com, there can be a point. Now, I'm not sure if there can be a point in the first place. I would doubt, but I would also wouldn't be surprised. So I'm just going to assume that the first instance will be either a number or a letter. And after we have that, we can match at least one point. And this is basically a requirement. There needs to be at least one symbol and one point. And then again, we have that at least once. For example, here we have Jeff, at least one letter or number, and then an optional point, or as we can see here, a subtraction sign. And that can repeat as often as we want. For example, here it repeats 3 times, could repeat 15 times, and the like. I think the maximum is like 248 or 256 bits of length, so you could have a lot of stuff standing here. Then at some point there has to be an @ sign, because you have to go back to the domain. Then we have the same pattern. We can have miami.edu, miami.edu.com, and the like. There could be a lot at the tail end here, so we have to account for that as well. It can happen one or more times. And then here we have to account for the last item. There needs to be a point at some. At some time there needs to be a point, because we have to go to the top level or country level domain. So here in the front it can be optional, but at one point there simply needs to be one. And after that there needs to be at least one letter. So I don't know, perhaps there could be a .99 or something at some point, but here we're just assuming it's like some very orthodox like .com, .org, .edu. Then, same as always, we create our regex with our pattern, get out our matches, and then we print them out for us. So let's just run this again. And here, again, it has worked. We see Max, he's a valid male. Mike was ignored because he has 2 @ signs. Jeff is here, of course, he wants to deliver us our packages. Tim, he is here as well, because this symbol is allowed. But Tom, with his invalid domain, he was ignored. Very nice. And then finally, we look into something where we don't just want to find out what matches exist, but we want to actually act upon this. We want to find the matches and then want to replace them in this instance. Say for example, you have a colleague or some supplier, customer, and they have a really weird way of storing information for you. For example, someone wrote a for each or for loop, and instead of having a fixed symbol, for example, a 1, they had an increment, and they saved your data like Max 2, Tim 3, Kathy, the program died, Terry 0, and Carl. And you know, okay, I have names which usually don't tend to include numbers unless you have a child named Caitlin with an 8, which unfortunately has happened before. And you just know, okay, it's just numbers. If I have a number, that means it separates two names. And with regex, it's very simple to use this. Namely, our pattern is simply, hey, okay, there is at least one number. If there is a number, please split. We just tell him that. And in this case, it's very interesting because it's just such a small item with such a big impact already. Then we can create our regex again, carry out the split command, and it will actually return us a string array, which we can then print out. Or if we just want to say, I don't even want the results, I just want to get out all the numbers and then have the string for something different, we can also say, hey, please also replace these matches for me. And in this case, as you can see here, we don't even need to create a new instance. We use a static class, which is also called regex, called regex.replace. While we give it our input string, our pattern, and the replacement string that should replace all the patterns that are found. And then we can write that down here as well. So let's just run this again. And yet again, we can see here, we have our string array that we print out one for one. And here we have the replace string with the subtraction sign. And with this, I would like to conclude and hope that you have learned something new that you can use in your time of development. I myself am quite new to programming, just started out in late 2020. But at some points, I think everyone should have a little look into regex because it can be so powerful and take off a lot of work from your plate. So with that, thank you very much for listening to me and have a nice day.